I just want to sit back and enjoy this wonderful opportunity to listen to Suzanne Vega.
Well, thank you. Well, let's do this one. Start with one that you mentioned. Even if I am in love with you, all this to say, what's it to you? Observe the blood, the rose tattoo of the fingerprints on me from you. Other evidence has shown that you and I are still lonely. Skirt around the danger zone and don't talk about it later. Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing. But the only soldier now is me. I'm fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny that I am changing. Marlena on the wall. Well, I walked to your house in the afternoon by the butcher shop with the sawdust strewn. Don't give away the goods too soon is what you might have told me. And I tried so hard to resist when you held me in your handsome fist and reminded me of the night we kissed and of why I should be leaving. Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing. But the only soldier now is me, fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny that I am changing. Marlena on the wall. And even if I am in with you, all this to say, what's it to you? Observe the blood, the rose tattoo of the fingerprints on me from you. Other evidence has shown that you and I are still alone. We skirt around the danger zone and don't talk about it later. And I tried so hard to resist when you held me in your handsome fist and reminded me of the night we kissed and of why I should be leaving. Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every man who's been here. But the only one here now is me, fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny that I am changing, 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 changing. Marlena watches from the wall. Her mocking smile says it all. She records the rise and fall of every soldier passing. But the only soldier now is me, fighting things I cannot see. I think it's called my destiny that I am changing. Marlena on the wall. Thank you, Christine. I see you doing that. That's very cute. I didn't know that. I didn't know that was the way to clap for these things. Well, I'm so thrilled to be doing this. Like everybody else, I'm having an old home week feeling in this show. Welcome to my little club. This is our library at home. So I'm going to do a song now, a couple of songs that sort of express the way I feel lately. The song is called Rock in This Pocket. And it's about the song of David and how he might have felt right before he threw that rock that he had in his pocket, David and Goliath. I know you're probably obsessed with the news the way I am, watching and waiting and thinking about November 3rd. And I can't help but think that that vote is like a rock that we each have in this pocket that we could throw, we could aim it, we could, and that we in fact have to do that. So
That's the mood of this song for me right now. Excuse me, if I may turn your attention my way. One moment, I won't plead. It isn't much, it's what I need. And what's so small to you is so large to me. If it's the last thing I do, I make you see. You turn from me, you darken my sun. You snap that thin thread I call my horizon. And I'd like to remind you of something small, that the rock in this pocket could cause your fall. And what's so small to you is so large to me. If it's the last thing I do, I'll make you see. So small to you, it's so large to me. If it's the last thing I do, I'll make you see. A light extinguished in the throw, but I'll hit my mark and you'll know. 'Cause I'm really well acquainted with the span of your brow. If you didn't know me then, you'll know me now. You'll know me now. And what's so small to you is so large to me. If it's the last thing I do, I'll make you see. So small to you and so large to me. If it's the last thing I do, I'll make you see. Make you see, make you see. Thank you. So I'm going to do an a cappella song now. It's a song I wrote after the president of the Czech Republic passed away. His name was Václav Havel. And I admired him as a person, and I got to know him a little bit in the last 5 years of his life. And I was so impressed with how he lived. He was a man who stood for love, really, in the way that he lived, in the way that he he signed everything with a little pink heart, and it was his philosophy, and it was and when he died, I missed him. So I wanted to write a song about that, sort of summed up his life. And I realized after I wrote the song that he wasn't the only one. There are several people who could have fit the profile in this song. So I didn't write it a cappella, but I'm going to sing it a cappella now. There is a road beyond this one. It's called the path we don't yet take. I can feel how it longs to be entered upon. It calls to me with a cry and an ache. And as we go along this one, and we live the way we do, love pulls us on to that distant horizon so true. I knew a man, he lived in jail, and his tale is often told. He dreamed of that line that we call the divine, and when he was free, he led his country. Yes, he taught the way of love, and he lived in that way too. Love pulled him on to that distant horizon so true. And there's a little trumpet solo. Da-da, 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 da-da. Da-da, da-da, da-da-da, da-da, 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 da-da-da. There is a road beyond this one. It's called the path we don't yet take. I can feel how it longs to be entered upon. It calls to me with a cry and an ache as we go along this one, and we live the way we do. Love pulls us on to that distant horizon. Love pulled him on to that perfect horizon. Love pulls us on to that distant horizon so true. That's how I feel about that. So, do I have time for one more tiny little song? Okay. I'll do another a cappella one. And this is one you probably know, but I figure I should do it, you know. It's a song about a diner up on 112th Street and Broadway. I am sitting in the morning at the diner on the corner. I am waiting at the counter for the man to pour the coffee, and he fills it only halfway. And before I even argue, he is looking out the window at somebody coming in. It is always nice to see you, says the man behind the counter to the woman who has come in. She is shaking her umbrella, and I look the other way as they are kissing their hellos, and I'm pretending not to see them, and instead I pour the milk. I open up the paper. There's a story of an actor who had died while he was drinking. It was no one I had heard of. And I'm turning to the horoscope and looking for the funnies when I'm feeling someone watching me. And so I raise my head. There's a woman on the outside looking inside. Does she see me? No, she does not really see me, 'cause she sees her own reflection. And I'm trying not to notice that she's hitching up her skirt, and while she's straightening her stockings, her hair has gotten wet. Oh, this rain, it will continue through the morning as I'm listening to the bells of the cathedral. I am thinking of your voice and of the midnight picnic once upon a time before the rain began. And I finish up my coffee and it's time to catch the train Thank you very much. I just want to do one little announcement. This is an album that's coming out on 9/11. It's called An Evening of New York Songs and Stories, and it was recorded last year at the Carlisle Cafe. So there's that. Mwah! Thank you so much for having me. Thank you, Christine. It's so nice to see you. Thank you, Rod. Thank you. Mwah.